Hi, Bob here. Welcome to 4 mindfulness exercises to reduce stress. I'm in my backyard and I'm seated on my steps. I would like you to find a chair or a step somewhere and get relaxed. Number one, the breathe bubbles. And it's a form of deep breathing and blowing bubbles. So I'm going to sit up straight. So my shoulders are down, back a little bit, and relaxed. My head is in neutral, not down or up or turned, in neutral. Push my chin back into my neck a little bit, right there. Just relax for a second. So when I do this, I'm going to breathe in through my nose and blow out through my mouth. And when I breathe in through my nose, I'll feel my abdomen getting bigger. And when I blow out through my mouth, I'm going to pretend I'm blowing bubbles. That's why the exercise is called breathe bubbles. Okay? But the blowing out, I want to focus on that and get it as long as I can get it. I want to blow out as much air as possible and make it last as long as possible. So I breathe in a nice deep breath in through my nose. Blow out those bubbles until there's no left air left in my lungs. Again, breathe in. Maybe you'll even hear the bubbles or some spit or something will come out. Again. So try to breathe in for 4 seconds and blow out for 8, twice as many. Here we go. One more time, breathe in for 4. Blow out for 8, those bubbles. Now, of course, if you're not focusing on what you're doing, body position, breathing in and out, abdomen, you won't be able to do it. So let's try it again. Ignore the cardinal over there. And the, I think it's a chipmunk on this side. Here we go. Breathe bubbles. 4 breaths in. Or sort of 4 breathing in for 4 seconds and blowing out for 8. Some people like to, in the middle, hold the breath for 7 and then blow out. You decide if that's going to make your blood pressure go up or make you feel dizzy, just don't do it. I'm going to try it this time. So I'm going to breathe in for 4. Hold my breath for 7. And blow out for 8. Another thing I'd like to mention is when you're breathing in, try not to let your shoulders go up. Just fill up the abdomen here. Here we go. Breathe in. Hold it for 7. And blow out. For 8. So it's called the breathe, deep breathing, breathe bubbles. Okay, and maybe the 4, 7, 8 technique is used. Meditation or mindfulness exercise is called the body scan. If you want to do this with your eyes shut so that you're not distracted by the environment around you, that might be easier. But I'm going to try, because I've practiced this a lot, I'm going to try to body scan with my eyes open. So again, I'm sitting in neutral in a relaxed position in good posture, so I'm not slouching. Push my hips forward into neutral. And I'm going to start by scanning the top of my head. And what that means is that I'm thinking about any feelings I'm having up there, any sensations of temperature or maybe pressure or any kind of movement of any sort, any stress or pain, anything like that, any feelings I'm having at the top of my head. Focus in on that head, ignore those birds. If you're in your living room or wherever, it'll be a lot easier. Later, sometime, you can try taking this outside. So body scan, top of the head. Shut up, Robert, and let's just focus. Let's move into our eyes now. How do they feel? I have no pain, but I have a lot of dryness going on, and I must have some sinus problems, maybe thanks to COVID, because they feel like they're filled with water. My eyes. Let's shift down to the mouth. Well, it's not dry anyway. I do have saliva, but I think I've got too much saliva in there. And I think it's a sinus thing again, and I think it's COVID that did it to me. And I didn't remember getting any COVID virus in the last year, but some sinus problems have cropped up, and I'm feeling it in my mouth a little bit. Some spit or phlegm or whatever you call it. It's not in my throat. Tongue feels okay, it's not swollen, there's no pain in there, my teeth don't hurt. Let's shift to the ears. Now I'm outside and I can hear things that I normally wouldn't if I was inside. And if I was in a very, very quiet spot, I would maybe hear a little pulse beating in my ears. You can hear all those sounds though. Far away, train, cars, and close up. I do have a wax problem. My father had a lot of ear wax, and I have a wax problem. So maybe I should get that cleaned by the doctor. Don't ever stick any sharp things like bobby pins or Q-tips in your ears. Not a good idea. You need that ear for hearing, but for balance too. And don't worry about the shape of your ears. Everybody has one ear that looks a little bit different than the other. My ears are okay. Good. Shift down to your shoulders. You've got two of them, remember. How do they feel? Are you shrugging a lot? Do the blades give you any pain in the back? Have you got a great range of motion when you move? But how do they feel right now, just sitting here? Don't forget that trapezius muscle that goes over top of your shoulders, down your back, down your chest, up into your neck. It's kind of like a blanket. Lots of blood vessels in the trapezius muscle. It's a very important ball and socket joint too. But mine feel okay. Lots of people do things they shouldn't do and end up with shoulder problems, and it's not easy to fix. So the smart thing to do is to exercise on a regular basis and include the shoulders. Good work. Move to your hips. Your your hips and your abdomen. Any noises coming out of there? And I know I'm doing a lot of talking here, but I want you to think about sensations or feelings in these different body parts, moving from the top down to the bottom of your body. And temperature, remember, pressure, pain, any movement. And try this on a regular basis if you like this meditation mindfulness exercise. It'll help with the stress too. And do it without anybody around and maybe go outside. My stomach's fine. I don't feel constipated or anything. No diarrhea going on. I would know it in my guts, in my small intestines, my large intestines, if that was the case. But you know, I'm very careful most of the time in choosing my foods, and I know which ones give me gas, and I try to avoid those. My hips feel okay. No pain. I'm sitting here. I'm in a relaxed position too, and I'm not slouching. Move to your knees. So my legs are bent. They're 90 degrees at the knees. No pain. But I'm not moving. If I go for a walk later in the day, like I usually do, going down hills gives me pain. Only usually in the left knee and on the inside. It's probably one of those ligament problems. You've heard of ACL, anterior cruciate ligament, or something like that. Anyway, the name's not important, but where the pain is and how much you feel when you move might require you to check with your doctor. And I might do that, but I'm going to wait a while because the COVID thing bothers me and the doctor not being able to see me bothers me. I exercise every day, and especially my knees. And I don't work through pain. Shift down into your feet. So that means your ankles, the bottom of your feet, the toes. I know I have a bit of a bunion problem, or maybe it's the bunionette on the left foot. So I exercise that. I have an exercise for that, and I think I've included it in one of my workouts. But my feet feel okay. My skin gets kind of dry on the right heel, and all I do is, before I go to bed, I put lots of Vaseline on my heel, on the dry skin that's cracking. I had eczema when I was a kid. Anyway, and then I put a sock over it, just that one foot. That helps a lot. And sometimes I do it, like if I'm going to the Y for a swim, when I come out, I do it then. I only have to put it on my one heel on the right side. But my feet feel okay, but I have to exercise those toes using my fingers and pushing them in between the toes to try to get them apart, bending the toes in different directions and stuff. But otherwise, my toes feel pretty good. Okay, so this is been longer than a minute, but when you're doing this, maybe just a minute and scan each one of those areas and check for feelings. Number three mindfulness exercise is called gray noise, and we're going to sit in a comfortable position and just try to take in all the sounds around us, whether you're in your living room or anywhere else, for about a minute. I'll listen. You can help me listen because you're going to be watching me and you'll hear the sounds I'm hearing, hopefully. And then we'll talk about them at the end. Here we go. Thank you. That's about a minute. Open your eyes up. Well, I heard that to my left, a compressor or some machine. There must be construction going over there, on over there. And these birds are out here, and I'm learning the different birds by their sounds. The grackle, I can hear it go, that one. There's some robins. Sometimes I hear the dove, but I didn't this morning. Anyway, and then there's the traffic. There's the traffic of the cars that are close to my house. I can hear that. And I heard something in the sky. Anyway, I was only doing it for a minute. My eyes were shut and I was trying to focus. And the last mindfulness exercise I have for you this morning, number 4, is called the rainstorm. You might know this one. It's kind of fun, but remember, we're trying to focus on something that's positive, and when we do these exercises, and that will help you with your stress for sure. So the rainstorm. First thing I want you to do is snap your fingers, and if you don't know how to do that, you can just sort of rub them back and forth like this, and let's listen to the sound of the fingers. And if you can't do that, you want to just do it with one hand, that's okay. But this is the beginning of the rainstorm. And we're supposed to get rain today and tomorrow. Then you're going to rub your hands together. Different sound. A little bit more rain coming. Then you're going to clap them. Does that sound like rain to you? Maybe faster. It's raining a little harder now. Birds are out again. Rainstorm's over. Maybe it wasn't a storm, it's just a rain. Let's try one more time. I won't talk. Try to focus and imagine it as rain. Rainstorm. So choose one of those mindfulness exercises and try them every day. Do more than one if you want. I guarantee it'll help you with your stress.